Hello everyone, and welcome back to Mick's Guide to Redstone, episode 2. This is the guide where I try to make videos that explain how redstone components work, all the way down from very beginner level and all the way up to more complicated stuff. And I will be making these videos as long as people show interest, and we will move on to, in the end, some more complicated stuff. These are the blocks I want to talk about today. Start off with the piston. A piston in Minecraft has the feature of pushing blocks, one block exactly in the direction that it's facing. It can be facing in six directions, up, down, north, south, and east. You can power a piston basically anywhere alongside of it. The only place you cannot power a piston is through its head. You cannot give it power like so. That is the only place that you cannot power a piston. A piston has a push limit of 12 blocks, and it will push blocks in one direction only for one block. Normal pistons will leave the block in the spot that it got pushed to. If we extend this, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That is the piston push limit, which means that it cannot push any further. If you remove one block, this is now 11, and we can push it. That is the most basics of a piston. Then there's the sticky piston. Sticky pistons have the feature that they do not leave the block. The block will stay with the piston, like so. The only difference is really that. A piston takes 2 ticks to extend, and 0 ticks to retract, which means that the delay of the block to go to this spot is 2 ticks. The delay for it to get back to this spot is immediately. The other really important thing to know about sticky pistons is that while the normal piston leaves the block like that, you can get the same effect on a sticky piston if you power it and then immediately unpower it. With basically a tick below one, a pulse below one tick in duration from on to off, the piston will, well, I should really say under 2 ticks, but what is happening is that it takes 2 ticks for the piston to extend. So if you power it, in the 2 ticks it takes to go down here, it will have processed that this block in the code. The game already knows as soon as you give it power that in 2 ticks, this block should really be over here, which is kind of a teleportation. But you have unpowered it, so in the process of the piston moving the block over here, this piston is actually already retracting before the block is over here, which means that they sort of separate from each other. That's the best explanation I can give. I'll do it with a block, that's faster. Like that. And vice versa, really. What you can do is that this is called a T flip-flop, which is basically you press once and you change the state of a piston or like a power source. It's called a toggling and it's called a T flip-flop. What you can do is that you can make something called a monostable circuit, which takes a pulse and limits the pulse length to what you want. So let's say you want a one tick pulse. What you can do is that you can make the bulk standard monostable circuit, which I will show you how to make right now. Basically what you do is that you do like this, and then in the middle you have a sticky piston facing up with a block on. You have a redstone dust a repeater, I mean, going into a redstone dust and then going into a piston. What this will do is that This repeater will send power into this block, which obviously strong powers this block, which means that it can power redstone. Then it will power this block, obviously making it extend. But also, this repeater is doing something a little bit weird called butt powering, which stands for block update detecting. This piston, which means that it will actually extend. And I will show you a little bit about that later, or after this. Which means that it is pushing the block up immediately, which means that it's removing power for this dust. So this dust will only stay on for one tick, which is the speed that it takes for a piston to retract itself with the block. So if I take a button instead of a lever, put it here. These have to be swapped around. I always get these wrong, but there you go. It will actually spit the block out, which means that we're now changing in between a state. So this is a monostable circuit. It shortens the pulse length. And this is a T flip flop. I mean, the entire thing is a T flip flop, but this is the part of it really doing the flip flop part. Right, so let's get into BOD powering, BUD powering, which I talked about before. It's called block update detecting, which is the idea that there is a feature. Used to be a bug, it's a feature now. Mojang has said that it's basically a feature. That if you power a piston one block above it, that means in this location, that's technically like right one block above it. This is one block above it. This is one block above it. This is one block above it. And this. This can be done with redstone dust too. What happens is that whenever you update the piston, it will extend. Why does it do this? I don't know. Used to be a bug. Thing is though, it will actually not retract before you update it again, which is why it's called block update detecting. A block update can be many things. It can be when a block changes, when there's added a block, when there's removed the block. It can be addition of power or removal of power. It can be a lot of things, really. Like, I'll give you a good example that many people use, which is a string. If you place a string above it, and then do like this, and remove that, a string actually does a block update detection. And changes its block whenever it's walked on. The reason it does this is because it needs that feature for when it's between two tripwires, so that you can like take a signal from that. It needs to update it, but it does it regardless if it's hooked or not, which means that if I now touch this one, that piston actually retracts. So a block update can be many things. Right. Now, I want to go to the last block now. Before I want to do a little demonstration of something I made like a year ago, which will be kind of a tutorial or build along for you to try out. An observer is basically a block update detector, kind of like we just did with the piston, but this is Mojang's version of it, like the intended to use version, which has sometimes you want to use the other kind, sometimes you want to use this. Can't really explain in a good fashion when to use one and when to use another, but that will come in when you start to make your own redstone designs. So there's two components really to a observer block. It has the face that detects, and it has the output that gives the power. So if you do any kind of update here, It sends a pulse through, basically. Like so. And it's also a it's a one tick pulse, really, so it takes one tick or 100 milliseconds, as we learned in the other one. 100 milliseconds to get through this thing. And it lasts. So the delay is one tick, and the duration or the pulse length is one tick. Pretty interesting. It has some other interesting things. What should we talk about? It has the ability to, because it updates itself whenever it detects an update. So if you face two of them into each other, it makes a that would be a two tick clock. I believe that's a two tick clock. Yep, it is. It is a two tick clock. Because this one, whenever you place this block down, this one detects that, which means that this is now in the powered state, which this one then detects, which is now in the powered state. Then was this one unpowers, and it loops like that. A observer does a weak powering. It doesn't strong power stuff. It weaks power stuff, which as we've learned. That means that let me just do something really quick. I mean, it doesn't it strong powers, but it doesn't detect weak power. That's what I'm kind of saying, which means that this redstone dust is now weak powering this block. But even though I. How can I do that so you can see? You can see like this, right? Yeah. It doesn't actually re activate that redstone dust. It doesn't detect weak power. However, it does detect direct redstone change. And it doesn't detect like power going into a block. You see? Okay. That is the observer. Also, this thing can be moved. It's a movable block. The redstone block is just a power source, really. Which is also a movable power source. It's pretty neat. I don't think that there isn't much explanation needed to do there. Now I'll get into the contraption that I made a few years ago, and this will be a build along, and I will try to explain how it works. First off, you want to get into the air or whatever where you want to build this thing. You want to start up with three blocks like this. You want to go down two, and place two pistons facing into each other, or like facing the same direction. One block below this, and then with this one block to spare, nothing here. You want to place a repeater in the middle and set it to two ticks with redstone dust on each side. Now you want to come to the other side, and you want to place a sticky piston on both sides of a power line above. You want to take any kind of block and use it on the faces of the three pistons here. I choose glass, which will make sense in a bit. You want to go from the middle block of your power line and go one down on diagonal and have a block there. Now you want to replace a repeater here, set it to four ticks, and now you want to route this redstone down into this thing, which you can do by just placing a block here, here, and here. That is, there's multiple ways of powering this. And if I have done this correctly, we should see if I take a lever and a button, that if I press this one here and this one here, that this is a double piston extender. And I call this one the magical floating seamless double piston extender, Because there's no actual redstone connected to the double piston extender part at any time. It's seemingly powered by the glass here, which obviously is not true. What is happening is called quasi-connectivity, which is that you can power pistons one block above them and they will detect an extent whenever they get updated. So how does this work? I'll try to do a simple explanation of it. It can get, if you need to do every single step, it becomes a little complicated. When you flick this lever, you have power all the way, like immediately basically. This power gets, blocks get powered, which makes this glass block butt powered. And then like two ticks later, this is powered. Then here's what really happens. This piston immediately gets BOD powered, which means that it can do this. Basically what happens is that this gets block update detect powered this piston, and then in the same tick this piston is extending, which takes two ticks, which then updates this piston, which then now it takes two ticks for this piston to move in here. But this block, as soon as this piston is moving in here, it's already powered by this block, which means that it basically, as soon as the two ticks is going here, will power this piston, extending it. Now, basically, when you unpower it, the exact same thing happens, but in reverse, which means that if I do it like this, that happens. Basically, exactly the same, but in reverse. And then, what the last thing is used for is that when you power this one, like four ticks later, it is the last thing that is supposed to happen. Because we now power directly into, we strong power into this block, it block up the takes, it sends basically power through to this block because it's strong powered, which block up the block update detects about powers this piston, which will have been retracted, which means that in the state of retracting it gets an update, which then updates this piston. And what happens is that this one gets extended, then this power is obviously gone, and then boom, and that is all of it. It in its simplicity, really. It's I like it. Okay, I hope this tutorial helped. If there's any questions, if there's any suggestions for what to do next, please leave them in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thank you very much for watching.